my YouTubians, ODYSEEans, Slayin' Saiyans, Cobra Kai's, and my pumpkin who be smashing. I'm Asherella, this is Original Asherella, and today we're going to be listening to and discussing and sharing our thoughts and our feels on the song that is arguably the Smashing Pumpkin song that started it all, Shee-va. This is the very first Smashing Pumpkin single from the very first Smashing Pumpkins album, and Billy Corgan and the band has said a lot about this song over the years, so there is a lot to talk about, and we're going to get into it real quickly. I'm not going to talk too much in the intro, but before we get into it, if you're watching on YouTube, subscribe to the channel. If you're watching on ODYSEE, follow the channel. You can gently press the notification bell on either platform so you know every time I upload a video. Leave me a comment, leave me a like, watch till the end of the video, and follow me on the social things, the X thing, the Threads thing, and the Insta thing. All right, y'all, Shee-va or Siva, if I dare. Now, it is pronounced Shee-va, but to be honest with you, when I read it in my head, I still say Siva, because many, 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 many years ago when I was a youngster and I first had the album and I first saw the song title and I first saw the video on the screen and that kind of thing, Siva is how it's spelled. But we know that, you know, fearless leader, Lord and Savior William Patrick Corgan pronounces it Shee-va, as in like the Hindu Shiva. So that's how we're going to pronounce it. But still to this day, after so many years of knowing it Shee-va, when I still see the word Siva, I think Siva, and I even like named one of my hairbrushes Siva many years ago. There was like the Diva, and then that one broke, and I had Siva, and then the third one was the Threeva, but that is a whole story for another day. I know who names their hairbrushes. Evidently, I do. But another story, another day. Anyway, okay, so we're not going to be listening to the album version of Shee-va today, and we're not going to be watching and listening to Shee-va through the music video. We're going to be watching and listening to Shee-va through the 1992 Reading Festival performance. Now, this is a great version, and you know, Shee-va's kind of a jam, and there's a lot of different live versions where they kind of tangent off into places, but I love this one. It's fun. Why not? If we've got it to watch, we're going to watch it this way. And this is from the 90s Live Archive YouTube channel is where I pulled this from, and they also performed Bury Me in this specific performance, but we're just gonna be listening to Shee-va. So without me yakking on, let's get into it. Okay, nothing, no mistaking that intro, am I right? You know, Billy Corgan has been quoted in saying that, like, Shee-va, this song, was really, like, the first song the Pumpkins, like, composed that was, like, this is defining the Pumpkin sound. And we know that early Smashing Pumpkins had, especially Gish, there's a lot of psychedelic kind of rock influences. It's definitely the closest to quote-unquote grunge that the Pumpkins Gish, but I do not consider the Pumpkins a grunge band because they're not grunge. You know, we have more hints of grunge in Gish than in other albums, certainly, but to say it's grunge, I don't think so. It was ranked like the 32nd greatest grunge album of all time, but I don't deny them the honor of that, but I just think that Rolling Stone doesn't know how to define grunge properly. But anyway, yeah, Billy has said that this was like one of the songs that really, you know, solidified what the Pumpkins were gonna sound like, and that he felt like, okay, this band is gonna work. You know, not even just like the instrumental and the sound, like, you know, right out the gate from the very first single, you know, we know what Billy Corgan's lyric style is like and all about, and how it is very different from anything else that anybody else has ever done. You know, and I love this because we have one of those classic Smashing Pumpkins tempo changes where it's like, what are we? Are we playing a different song now? And it's like, no, we are not. But this is how we do things, and it works so well. Oh my God. James Iha is beautiful, like in a dress or in a suit. Oh my God, is James not gorgeous? Like, sometimes I like kind of lust him, and then like sometimes I'm kind of jealous of him, how pretty he is. Like, all four of these people on stage right now are, even way back in 1992, are fucking rock stars, you know, from like day one, for real. And it's really too bad how things had to go with Darcy, you know? Alright guys, so you have it, Shee-va live in 1992. So fun, such a fun performance. It seems like the band's having a great time. You know, that was the early days for sure, but you know, Gish is such a fantastic album. And you know, it doesn't sound anything like Siamese Dream, and Siamese Dream doesn't sound anything like Melancholy, and Melancholy doesn't sound anything like Adore and Machina and so on. And you know, that's one of the things that makes the Smashing Pumpkins great. While they certainly are the same band and have elements of the same sound, none of their albums sound like the one before it, even though their sound is so determined and it's so specific, which is so weird to say about the Pumpkins because they cross so many genres and they, you know, use so many tempos and they use so many instruments and, you know, their genres just fluctuate so much. I don't know. But, like, if you know when you listen to the Pumpkins and you've, you know, really put time into listening to them, then you know what I mean. A couple years back when it was, like, the Gish 30th anniversary, Billy did a live stream, which is amazing because it was on my birthday, I think. Or maybe it was the day before or after my birthday, but I know it was, like, right around my birthday because that was, like, what I did for my birthday was watch, I was kind of in hiding at that time, watch this Billy Corgan live stream where he literally, like, broke down all of the, like, songs on Gish and talked about, like, the recording process and the meaning of the song. And all of those videos are available on YouTube, on the Smashing Pumpkins YouTube channel. So if you've never watched that, go check it out. It's so great. It's really insightful as far as, like, you know, the album goes. And, you know, you get to hear what Billy has to say about each song individually. And it's a really, really good listen. So I definitely encourage you to check it out. And then also, like, for the Gish 30th anniversary, they did, like, a live listening party that you had to buy tickets to. There was a live stream from Madame Zuzu's, and it was Billy and Jimmy basically just listening to the record. And that happened, was that at my birthday? And it was it like the year before he did the live stream? Because I know both things happened around my birthday, but it was in different years. So I think the Madame Zuzu's live stream was the actual anniversary year, but it was like the year before that, that Billy did the breakdown of all of the, you know, all the songs. But anyway, it was really great, and my mom actually bought me a ticket to the live stream for my birthday that year because I don't have much else going on other than the Pumpkins. No, I'm just kidding. I do, sort of. But, anywho, I guess I'm gonna stop chatting now. I do want to say that I had to take my hat off to film the video. No, I wear a lot of hats. I wear many hats, like, literally, sometimes figuratively, but whenever I filmed the intro and I sat down to film this part of the video, I was like, oh crap, like, I can't put my headphones on over my hat. And I do wear a lot of hats, but most of the hats that I wear are kind of like beanie or beret style, so my headphones fit over them perfectly. And I did not think about that with this hat. And, you know, I think I love this hat. When I got it, I'm like, is it giving blossom or is it giving, like, ultraviolence? And you know what? It gives neither. It gives Asherella. I love this hat, actually. It's maybe my new favorite hat. Too bad I cannot film with it on. But anywho, that's it for today, guys. Let me know what you think of Shee-va. Let me know what you think of Gish. Did you watch either of those Billy Corgan live streams that I was talking about where he discusses Gish? Let me know all your thoughts and feels down in the comments below. I'm Asherella. This is Original Asherella. If you're watching on YouTube, subscribe to the channel. If you're watching on Odyssey, follow the channel. You can gently press the notification bell on either platform so you know every time I upload a video. Leave me a like. Leave me a comment. Go to your social things. Find me on my social things. The X thing, the Threads thing, and the Insta thing, and then follow me there. Go to Twitch, find Original Asherella on Twitch, and then tune in on Sundays at 8-ish Eastern Standard Time for Kino and Commentary. We're off for a few weeks, but we will be back in the relatively near future, so check that out here soon down the road. It's a movie show, different content than here, but still a really good time. You know, there's not big pumpkin energy over there like there is here, but we do watch good movies. Always tap in. Never tap out, and don't forget to keep on smashing like a pumpkin.